Hey guys, so probably a quick video today. I don't have too much in the way of books to look at. I picked up my saver just a few days ago, and you know, I'm getting a lot less, so but let's take a look. Plus, honestly, I don't have a huge amount of time to be reading what I do pick up. I just sat and read some Batman yesterday, maybe the day before, and I was able to grab a few minutes and finish up the Human Target series by Tom King. So I finished that up. I'm honestly surprised how that ended. I don't, you know, I have a pile of comics to read, and that's not even counting what I have in, you know, long boxes, collections that I haven't, you know, even cracked open yet. So honestly, I could probably stop buying comics for like a year, and I would still have enough to be reading, you know, every day if I wanted to, just from stuff I've bought and put to the side. Anyway, so here is, we got Daredevil number 10. I've liked this Daredevil run by Zdarsky. I think he's doing a great job. I know the previous cover had Daredevil and Punisher on it. I'm not sure what's going on with this, what looks to me to be a Captain America ripoff shield there, so I don't know if that's something Punisher was using or Daredevil's using, but I will find out. I think I read the first three issues so far of this reboot, but I'm obviously behind. And then we have Daredevil number 11. Looks like they've added a guest starring story. Oh lord. For Iron Fist, and increased the price by $1. So I never like it when they do that, because, I mean, apart from Zdarsky's Batman, which has him writing the backup stories, a lot of the times when they throw a story or a guest story in the back and increase it by $1, I've never really found those backup stories to be worth that $1 increase. You know, sad to say. And a good amount of times I will just flip past them. I find the art to be rather Marvel Comics Presents, you know, level, you know, where maybe they just have a new guy come in and see what he can do. So that's unfortunate. Hopefully that's not a ongoing thing. This Iron Fist backup is by somebody whose name I don't recognize, so that's already a not a great sign. X-Men number 11. When I picked this up, the scroll up a little bit. When I picked this up, the cashier was actually, oh, you know, that's ending soon. Marvel, after after they rebooted the X-Men with that fanfare and had Hickman on the book, you know, he did his thing for a while. It was great. And then once he wanted to take a break, I swear they don't know what they are. I don't think they know what they want to do with the X-Men now. You know, they still have this trade dress like Hickman's on it. I don't know if he's behind the scenes still and steering this ship while letting other people in the engine room. But it sure seems like they, you know, after his very... his mainline run and a very small amount of books, it seemed like they just exploded the line and, you know, added a whole bunch of the, you know, X-Force and Extreme X-Men and, you know, the kind of things they did in the 90s when they had 50 different X-Men books. It seems to me like they've done that again. So, you know, when you have 50 books in the same universe, I really don't think you can have them all be as as compelling as they should be. And then last comic that I have here is Batman number 900, because this is the legacy number 900. I like how they'll renumber it. There's a number 135, but legacy-wise, it's number 900. And they want to make sure they price tag it at $6.99 when it's a legacy number that they can throw on there. Zdarsky's Batman I've liked. Right now Batman's in a alternate universe, and I was honestly surprised that's the direction they went. But here we are. You know, DC right now is so hard for me to keep track of, quite honestly, because since I aren't in previews anymore, or at least not for free. Like, if you have a, I guess, like a membership, or you've signed up for a previews account, you can look in your pull box for DC books and see what's coming out that week. Otherwise, it's just hidden because DC didn't want to pay Diamond, and now they're through their own distributor. I find it harder to keep track of what DC is doing and what they have coming out, because I can't just go to Diamond's previews website and look. I find that to be, I think it's really short-sighted of them. I think they probably get a little bit more money off of the books, obviously, because they don't have to work with a distributor. But you're missing, like, all of that free advertising to a large extent. So, you know, I know they've done this. They have this Dawn of DC trade dress on here, which I've seen a few ads for inside the books themselves. And it says, you know, new creative teams, new stories. I don't even know what that is, because it's like a one-page thing in this book, and there's no, a lot of those ads don't tell you who the new creators are or what the new books are. So how, you know, you want me to care, but you're making it hard for me to care. I, you know, and look, I'm not going to go to the DC Comics website. Last time I was there, it was a cluster. And, you know, if you had it on previews, I would look and maybe I'd pick up some more books. But if I have to go out of my way, I'm not going to, especially when I'm trying not to spend too much money. So, there you go. Other thing I picked up that I wanted to show you guys is the, I got the FTR Unrivaled Collection Series 12 figures, which are, you know, I love FTR the team, but these figures, I had heard they weren't great. They look better to me than the last FDR figures, but they still have a lot to work on. I mean, like Dax here, he's been rocking just a mustache for like 2 freaking years, and they still have him with a beard, and they can't get his face right to save their lives. Some of these figures, it seems like they do head scans. And other ones, I mean, look at this on the back. That's just a mustache. It's a big Tom Selleck 70s, 80s mustache. So, what the frig is this? This isn't the same. And it would be one thing if you could kind of, paint over the beard, but it's, you know, raised up, so I couldn't even fix it with a Sharpie if I wanted. But, yeah, I mean, it seems like some people, they do a head scan, like, actually go somewhere and do a head scan. And then some people, they try to wing it. And you can just tell when they wing it, it is not great. You know, like, out of this set, I think Mark Quinn, they got pretty well. Isaiah Cassidy, everybody said it looked like just random black dude. I think they probably did a head scan for Jamie Hayter, because she was pretty much on point. Moxley, honestly, I don't think they've ever gotten I'll tell you the truth. Especially a lot of the times, it's like, I don't, maybe they do a head scan and he grimaces. But a lot of the head scans are their heads for the Moxley figures. He's like making stupid faces. And I don't know if they're having him come in and he's doing that. If they are, he needs to stop. We also got Cash Wheeler. I wish they put some like chest hair on some of these guys. Like Cash has a good amount of chest hair. Put that on there, it'd be, make it a little bit more, of a resemblance. I think his heads are a little bit better, if only because they got his hair and facial hair correct. But if you're gonna do a figure of these guys and you have the technology to do a 3D head scan, then do a 3D head scan, and you know, let's put some work into these. You know, they're the tag team champs. They're they've got a huge following. Let's put some work into it. You know, like the Kenny Omegas. You can tell they did a head scan of him because it's like on point. Same thing with the Jericho, especially the first couple. Looking at it, it's hard to say on the Lucha Brothers because they have masks, but like the original Jericho and the Kenny Omegas from the Unmatched Collection have been, you can tell they're doing a head scan of that person and they're putting work into it, but so many of these other characters kind of get the shaft, so I don't know. I picked it up basically because I love FDR and I want to support them, but this facial hair alone is such a stupid and obvious like thing they could have fixed. I mean, how long does it take you to just grind off the beard, put a bigger mustache? That's all you had to do and he would look 10 times more like Dax. I don't know, but that's all I have today. I don't have much in the way of magic stuff. I've built a couple decks because I can't stop myself from doing that. Right now I'm just trying to make sure that I have money for when the Lord of the Rings set drops, because I really want to make a Gandalf deck just because it's Gandalf. Even though he's, so far it looks like he's red and blue, which are not colors that I would normally want to play, but have to save some money up for that. So I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know what you think about FDR here. I wish they did a better job on these guys, but this is what we got.